Following, President Museveni's appointment of Edward Akol, a certified public accountant, as the next Auditor General replacing long-serving John Mwanga yesterday. The Appointments Committee of Parliament, chaired by the Speaker of Parliament Anita Among, vetted and assessed whether Edward Akol had the required competences for the job. Akol, party to replace John Mwanga, began working with the Office of the Auditor General in 1994, rising to his current post as the Assistant Auditor General in charge of audit. He had previously served as a Senior Auditor and Senior Principal Auditor. Mwanga is retiring from his position by Uganda's retirement age cap and has been in office since 2001.
I will miss you all, because it's been like a family, and it's been helpful to me, and my success, if I may say that, has been on your support to me, such that everything went well and it came to a beautiful conclusion.
Speaking of some legislators, he expressed optimism about the incoming Auditor General, highlighting his capacity based on the vast experience he has acquired over time, having worked with the Auditor General's office for close to 30 years.
We have seriously given, issued, I think, a warning through this opportunity of vetting that they should be more transparent as an office of Auditor General. And we have also emphasized that from the cliche of watching the watchers, the Attorney General, also that office ought to be ready to be audited.
Most of these audit queries have been done by him, the biggest. And he has been in that office for quite long. But the issue of the treasury operations, because you know Uganda's debts are more than the budget itself. So what is he going to do? He needs to audit that area, which is vote 130 in finance.
Also vetted were appointed judges Lillian Linda Tumusimi and Anthony Patrick Wabwire, who were recently nominated to the Industrial Court. These separately appeared before the committee. A section of both primary and secondary schools in Busia District have embraced practicing Olympic Games to help promote learners' talents. The National Olympic Africa Youth Center, located in Mayombe, Dabani Sub-County, has attracted pupils and students in Busia District to take part in various sports activities such as football, athletics, weightlifting, netball, as well as Paralympic Games for those living with disabilities. Mustafa Mgero, the director of the Olympic Africa Youth Center, a facility where these youth train, says that they train youngsters from the age of 6 and expose them to various sporting activities.
Uganda Olympic Committee over National Olympic Committee, Uganda. National Council of Sports.
For self-discovery. However, Auma Emily, a teacher at Dabani Boys Primary School, highlights some of the challenges faced by the schools and pupils in pursuit of sports careers.
Program planners to help us with the things like you get, okay, like me, my schools, they're lacking uniforms. You get these young girls opening their legs, which is not good. So, me, I'm requesting the uniforms.
Coaches, boxing, equipment.
The facility, which works in collaboration with the National Council of Sports as well as the National Olympic Committee, has seen various youth benefit from their sporting skills, and some have had exposure to represent Uganda in Malawi, Senegal, and Brazil. Britain voted yesterday, Thursday, in a general election that polls predict will hand the opposition Labour Party a landslide win and end nearly a decade and a half of Conservative rule. The first national ballot since Boris Johnson won the Tories, a decisive victory in 2019, follows Prime Minister Rishi Sunak. Sunak's surprise call to hold an election 6 months earlier than required. His gamble looks set to backfire, with polls throughout the six-week campaign and for the last 2 years pointing to a heavy defeat for the right-wing party. That would almost certainly put Labour leader Keir Starmer 61 in Downing Street as leader of the largest party in Parliament. Centre-left Labour is projected to win its first general election since 2005 by historic proportions, with a flurry of election eve polls all forecasting its biggest ever victory. But Starmer is taking nothing for granted as he urged voters not to stay at home. Britain's future is on the ballot, he said, but change will only happen if you vote for it. Sunak was among the early birds, casting his ballot at his Richmond and North Luton constituency in Yorkshire, Northern England. Starmer voted around 2 hours later in his North London seat shortly before Liberal Democrat leader Ed Davey.